Hi, Merry Meet. So, I want to review another book, and it's a tiny one this time. It's How to Read an Egg, Divination for the Easily Bored, by Colette Brown. When I saw this book, I just had to have it, because it sounds so fun. It basically presents itself as being a book about odd and weird divination techniques from throughout history and around the world. And it is that. Sort of. But I have some issues with this book. The thing is, only about, you know, three or four of these techniques that are presented in there are actually rare and unusual ones. She also discusses things like tea leaf reading, which is bog common, the dowsing, which is bog common. I mean, psychometry, which is bog common. There's so many things that are just divination techniques that everybody has heard about. And it's not that these aren't good techniques. They are great techniques. They're probably far better than these more strange techniques. That's why they have become popular. And the other ones are related to curio books. So that's not the point. The point is this book, the way it is presented, is about the odd ones. It's supposed to be a fun read about various ways people have told fortunes throughout the ages, and some of those ways have been pretty strange. So the way the book is built up is that the author discusses a method, and then she has gotten some friends of hers to basically let her do this divination on them. And then she discusses the results and what she thought about the technique. And that would have been fun if she had kept to the more odd ones. But when she also, most of the book are about things that you can read about in books dedicated to those methods, which then are much better. And that you know, most people that would be interested in buying this book already knows the basic of. It gets a bit wasted. Other than that, the book's a fun little read. And there are some odd ones here. Basically, let me read from the back of the book. You have tried the tarot, ruminated with the runes, and are all angel carded out. Now try the less well-known, the tribal, the forgotten, and the truly bonkers. Divination, the art of production or psychic instinct, by use of supernatural means, can be acute. And fun, and can be accurate and fun. And I mean, all of it presents itself as being about these strange methods, but most of them are the normal ones. Yeah, sure, she has some of the odd ones, like method that uses basically uses your butt. It reads your butt cheeks and takes into account the shape of it, the firmness of it, scars, indentations, all of that to determine your past and future. Divination with an egg is just actually not that unusual. It's a pretty standard method. Basically, you take a glass of ice cold water and you crack an egg and you separate the yolk, isn't that it? From the. You only want the clear stuff, not the center of it, the yellow center of it. I can't remember what it's called in English. But anyway, you take that clear. If I think that's the yolk. No, is the yellow one the yolk? Anyway, the white stuff. You want the white stuff. And you pour that into a glass of ice cold water and you read the symbols and things that you can see in the swirls before it ends up on the bottom of the glass. It's actually a pretty famous method because it was the one that Tituba was reported to teach the preacher's niece and daughter to do in Salem. So a lot of people have heard about it, but it's still not that usually practiced. So it's a good one included there. You have reading with wine, which can be a fun one. It's basically like exactly the same that you would read tarot. No, I mean, my head doesn't work, that you would read tea leaves or coffee, or the basically coffee powder that's left. You would read the stains left on your glass when you drink wine. But there's a lot of those little fun ones. My point is, there's so many of these divination methods. I have a book at home I completely forgot what it's called. Seems this video is a bit disorganized. But I think it's like the 1001 psychic encyclopedia. I don't know. It's from the same company that makes those 5001 spells and such. Anyway, it just goes through a lot of divination methods, and some of them, I would have loved to see those in a book like this. Like, for example, Divination by Watching Cats Play. I like that one. Though I have a feeling I would be distracted by the cutie kittens and forget about my divination, but that's so. Divination by Animal Tracks. This basically anything that you have ever had some sort of randomness to, people have been using for divination. So there's so many things they could have done, and it seems like she ran out of ideas halfway through the book. Now, when that is said, the book is written in a fun way. It's a fun little read. She's a decent author, and I mean, it's not that long a book to get through. It's the worst thing that you can spend a few hours on than reading this book. And if you do, like I did, get it secondhand and cheap, it's a pretty good way to spend your money. It's not a waste, but I do wish that she had spent more time on the more unusual methods instead of bringing psychometry and tea leaf reading and a few of those things that are so standard, because that doesn't fit with the theme of the book. So yeah, that's my review of How to Read an Egg, Divination for the Easily Bored by Colette Brown. I hope you have enjoyed this review. Have a great day, and blessed be.